Speech intelligibility. What is that? Well, the ability to understand, hear and understand what's being said or sung. The human voice has a what we call directivity or a radiation pattern. Directivity is normally referred to as a microphone directivity, like how is the pickup pattern of a microphone. But if you turn it around, what's the directivity of a sound source? Trumpet, we have a lot of sound coming towards the front, almost only. A kick, or not a kick, but a drum in the marching band, we have sound coming all over the place. The voice, we have sound coming mainly in front of us. As you see in this picture, that's the level of the voice. This is one person speaking for about 2 minutes, and then we have leveled the voice around the person. This is also done in an anechoic chamber. The person was speaking, and we moved the microphone around, or we had actually many microphones around the person, and then we measured the level. So that's not rocket science. We know that we have mostly level coming out in front of us when we speak. What is interesting here is the frequencies, the differences in frequencies around the person. The blue lines and the green lines are the higher frequencies. If you like, it's the consonants, the T's, all those sounds. And the red lines are all the lower frequencies, the vowels, if you like. So we have normalized it at 0 degrees. That means right in front of the person at level of the mouth. So when we normalize all the frequencies here, we see how they are attenuating once you go behind the person. But not so much the low end. So we are more or less omni in the lower frequencies when we speak. If we turn it around, we see that we have more level below the voice than we have above. But that doesn't mean that we have higher intelligibility below the voice. In this direction, 45 degrees below, you see that we have a lot of energy on some of the vowels. And those vowels, they take over from the consonants, the higher frequencies. So we have bad or worse intelligibility below than we have above, where we have a more, the orange and, no, the blue and the green there, they are more balanced than they are down here. So the experiment was that we took a microphone and placed it 1 meter away from a test person, 10 test persons actually, recorded that, and that was our reference. So that's our zero, that's the flat frequency response. It's not flat in the real world, but in this experiment we flattened it out, so this is the reference. Then we placed a microphone on the forehead of the person, and we measured the difference between the 1 meter away and the forehead position. So that's what you see here. We put one on the on over the ear and measured the difference. We put one on headset, like I'm wearing here, and measured the difference, and one on the chest and measured the difference. We did that 10 times. And this is the average of the forehead frequency response. The forehead is basically flat. This is the average of the ear position. We are losing a lot of the higher frequencies. And the cheek, the headset, we have a little more 1K on the middle part there, but we are still losing all the higher frequencies because we are behind the sound source. We are not right in front of it. So when we go behind the sound source, we are losing the higher frequencies. And the chest position, we have the worst of both worlds. We are below and we are behind. So we are losing a lot of high frequencies. And combined, that is mostly 3 kilohertz that we are losing. That is where all the consonants are. That is where the speech intelligibility is. So this position here is the worst position when it comes to speech. So never put the microphone here again. Never. Of course, you have to, because that's real world. You have to put the microphone here. That's where they want the microphone. It looks good, and it doesn't look as bad as when you put it right here. We get away with that in theater, but we won't get away with that in news. I don't think so. So put it here. But it's not that big a problem if you know what you're doing. If you know that you have a microphone that is flat, you know this, so you know how to compensate. I'd like to make this experiment here with you guys, or something similar, just to give you an idea of what does it sound like, so you know what to work around with when you are working with microphones placed here. So I'd like to ask one of you to volunteer to sit here in this hot chair and be recorded. Whoops. We'll just put microphones on the floor. That's fantastic. So do we have a volunteer? You would like to volunteer? Come up on stage. I have prepared four microphones. Four completely different microphones. One is black, one is brown, one is beige, one is gold. Was that four? I guess it was. So, and you can be my proof here that they are completely different, right?
They look different.
They look different, but inside they are identical. They have exactly the same sound, and we'll prove that. So you hold these four, hold them as close together as you can. Now it's a little bouquet, like give it to your loved ones. It's a very expensive bouquet. And if they're not into sound and they don't know what they're holding in their hands, it's waste. So, you see my Pro Tools again? Yes, you do. I have four tracks here. I will call it forehead. I'll put that on your forehead in a minute. Next one I will call ear. Cheek and chest. Boom. So now I would like you to talk into these four mics and hold it like level of your mouth right there. Yes.
Test, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Yeah, if you can say like what you had for breakfast or something interesting. Very light breakfast. Maybe something to consider. For me. I like breakfast. Can you see the waveforms there? Yeah. So they should sound the same. What I will do now, I will take them out of record and, there we are. And I will solo one part at a time, and I hope that...
All right, I had a...
I hope I can jump between the tracks.
All right, I had a yogurt with some muesli and honey and berries, and that's about it. All right, I had a yogurt with... Some muesli and honey and berries, and that's about it. All right, I had a yogurt with some muesli and honey and berries, and that's about it. All right, I had a yogurt with some muesli and honey and berries.
I'm jumping between the four microphones, and you can't hear the difference. So that's consistency for you. The microphones, despite their different colors, they sound exactly the same. They have the same level. You saw my interface here. These four tracks here are the over here, the inputs. So they sound the same. Good. Now I will place the four microphones on you, in your hair. No, I won't. We'll start with the beige.
Which one? This one? Or?
That's gold.
Blue.
Yes. And I don't have a stapler with me, so I'll just use tape today.
Fine by me.
It's fine? Thank you. I'll take it behind you. It won't hurt until later. It looks fantastic.
Okay.
And the brown? Where? That's black. Is it brown? I'll put that over your ear. And reason why we put it here is because it's very common in theater to put it up here, and I just want to show you what it sounds like. And the black one we'll put on your chest or on your shirt. There we go. And the headset, obviously, headset. There's an ear in there somewhere, right? Are you comfortable?
Yep, all good.
You're not supposed to. Looks beautiful. Do you have any friends here that will post pictures of you on Instagram?
Hope not.
Hope not, okay. Anyway, you will say what you had for breakfast again. And we will hear what happened to the sound just by moving the microphones around. Here you go.
This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things.
Sounds much more like my breakfast. All right. You see, something happened now, right? Levels are now east and west. I know from previous experiment that the forehead is the one that's closest to what we had before, so that will be my guiding point. I will change the volume on the file so it looks more or less like we have the same level. You see, the top one is the forehead, and next one is the ear. I had to boost that. I had to raise the level, of course, because we are behind. You saw on the graphics before that the level is decreasing when we go behind. The cheek or headset, I had to attenuate that 5 dB almost because we are so close to the sound source, of course. And the chest, a little more, couple of dBs, 2 dB up. So they now look like they have the same level, right? Do we agree? So they should sound the same now, right? But they don't. We will have the reference, we will have the pink noise. If you like, we'll have that on the forehead. Just go like this, boom. So that's the forehead, it sounds like this.
Cool, this time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool, this time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and...
It sounds very natural, right? Now the ear position.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things.
You hear we lost all the higher frequencies. I'll jump between them, the forehead first and then the ear.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things.
So ear.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool. This time I decided...
We're moving the microphone only like 10 centimeters from here to here, and it has It's night and day. Just that little movement. So headset sounds like this. I will compare it again with the forehead. The forehead is my pink noise. So starting with the forehead.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and...
And even though we are this close to the sound source, it still sounds muffled compared to the forehead. And the chest, starting with the forehead again.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes.
What do you hear? You hear muffled and you hear speech intelligibility gone. But if you didn't have the reference, if you didn't have the sound of the forehead.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things. Cool.
We can hear what he's saying. We can, now we've heard it 15 times, so we kind of understand. But we don't have a reference. We don't know where that muffling is coming from. Is that the position? Is it the clothing? Is it the speakers? Is it the room? Because we don't have anything to compare it with.
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes. And
so this could be fine. If we didn't know better, if we didn't know where the microphone was positioned, we just had this recording, and we didn't have our pink noise, we will just go for that. We'll just... Our ears are tuning in to everything that's missing in that 3K area, so we don't need to do much more. Our ears have done the rest. Problem is that we are losing speech intelligibility. We are not understanding as easily as we could if we had the...
Cool. This time I decided to have waffles and pancakes and French toast and other delicious things.
Now we have everything. We have all the details in the voice. So I'll just dismount you here. Ouch. No, it didn't hurt, did it? No. And the headset. Okay, I'll have to cut your hair. Good. Good. And the lab. So thank you very much. Cool. So reference. It's always nice to have a good reference so we know what we're working with, right? I encourage, as often as I can, people to, like in film, for instance, when they are placing microphone in a very compromised position. It could be, now here it was, the lab was right in the open, so it was not as bad as it could be. If you imagine that you put the microphone underneath the shirt, it's even worse, it's even more muffled. Or it put it closer to the cheek, you have more shadowing from the beard or from the hair or from the scarf or from whatever, so it will be even more muffled. So I always encourage sound engineers to make a reference recording. It could be the little bouquet, or it could be just put it on the forehead, record that mic, and then record the compromised position on the second track, and then leave this alone because that's your reference, your pink noise, and then make this one sound as good as that one with EQ or what have you, acoustic filters.